So everybody be preparing. Africa mostly be preparing for the rain and from Kenya. So let's pray. Let's pray concerning, they will say every day is Kenya. I'm in your country, so I'm always praying for the country. God keeps showing me stage by stage. So let's pray for the country, Kenya, in the place of, what I call it, rainfall, so that it will not cause chaos in rain. Uh-huh. So I've said it before, we are not going to put it as a prophecy out there. Uh-huh. So that is just it. And let's also pray against the judgment. People are judging Ruto for bringing new, for canceling or sacking the cabinet. That is the best decisions he took. So God is taking Kenya to the next level of prosperity. Despite no matter how it's going to be, Kenya will prosper again. Kenya will be peaceful, and everybody in this country, I see opportunities of job. So that's it. Apart from the tribal issue that will come out, God will settle it. Opportunities are coming. Eh? Opportunities are coming for this country. Yesterday when I went out, I saw the weather. So let's pray for the weather issues. You can DM me, no problem. And let's also pray. Kenya will be better. Things will work. Very good. Things will work in this country. So that's all I have to say. And for those people who are wishing the president to go, he's not going. He's the choice of God. The choice of God always comes with so many mistakes, so many challenges. So don't think the choice of God is so perfect. God chooses whom he wants to use. He makes the imperfect perfect. So the more you are saying Ruto go, God will keep him. The more you even agitate to say Ruto must go, he will see his second term. So that's it. I don't know what is going on. Thank you, Father. So let's pray concerning what they call it. Thank you, Father. Egypt. Egypt will also come out to protest. So Egypt will come out to. So people who say, I am copying or I'm checking the weather. So check if anybody has spoken about Egypt. Check if the weather forecast said Egypt, there will be agitation in Egypt. Are you understand me? Egypt, the Egypt you know that is developed, will have the same agitations, social unrest in their country, where the people will come out and say no. I don't know they will say no from, I don't know what they are saying no, but the Egyptians will also come out to protest. The revival of God is going to Egypt. After their protest, a church, a mighty church, will be raised by God in that country called Egypt. So we have to pray for every other citizens of any nation in Egypt, for God to help them. Let no one also die in the place of agitation. So after the agitation, a church, a very big church, will be established that will bring revival to the nation. That's what the Lord is talking about. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Father. In the name of Jesus. Let's keep praying for the United States earthquake. This earthquake is expanding. It's expanding. I don't know how to say it, but the earthquake the Lord is talking about is expanding. The earthquake is expanding. Let's keep praying for the US against earthquake. And let's also pray for France against earthquake. I'm seeing France having earthquake that is coming. I'm not a prophet of doom. If God gives me an information to talk to you, does not mean he's a doom. He's telling you to pray and prepare. So France are going to face those challenges of earthquake and storm. So earthquake is moving to France. Thank you. It now moved to France. And I'm seeing something like, not much, but it's like, I won't call it tsunami, but what are they calling that thing? Tornado. A little of tsunami, not a very big one, in Highland. The country, Highland, close to UK. So let's pray for Highland. I'm seeing tornado, and I'm seeing not much of tsunami, but water into the cities. You understand? And the Lord is also taking me to Australia. There's going to be a heavy protest in Australia. I don't know when. Is it going to be this year or next year? When is it going to be? There's going to be a social unrest in Australia. I don't know what they will be protesting about, but I saw people with placard in Australia. Australia. So after the Australia of that stuff or before, there is also going to be an earthquake. Australia is going to experience what I call what? Protests. And Australia will also have some storms, thunder, lightning, and what they call heavy storms in Australia. But the heavy storms will not bring earthquake to Australia by the special grace of God. But all the shakings will not affect. Thank you, Father. Lord, show me this flag. What is this flag they are doing? Dots, 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 dots. This. I see, is it blue? Something like blue flag. And I'm seeing star. Can somebody tell me? Yeah, it's a blue flag. So Australia is going to have a great storm, weather storm. But we pray fire doesn't. I pray fire doesn't occur. So, but after the storm, it will not affect Australia. That storm is trying to bring earthquake. But due to some certain church who have been praying for God's protection in that nation, Australia. So what was to happen in Australia now move to that country with flag, with star. As you say, it's New Zealand. It now moved. So the earthquake now happened in New Zealand. But first of all, the attack was to be in Australia. So God will now advert it to the neighboring country. So we should pray. So after this New Zealand, we should also pray for God to protect Taiwan, because Taiwan also we have some storms in their nation. Taiwan, we have some storms, a heavy storm concerning the weather, and that's it. So we should just pray. In the Europe nation, I saw the weather. This weather, there's going to be some signs in the weather in some Europe nations. Yeah, there's going to be some signs. You're going to see signs up in the sky. It's not addicted. We're going to see it in Europe. I'm specific about the Europe. In America, a different scary sign. So it will happen. I see Europe, I see America. Back here in Africa, I will not be specific. So we should just pray. In Africa, I won't be specific about the country, but we will also experience some written stuff in the sky. Don't be scared. Some of them will be scary. We'll see it. You understand? So it's very clear. And another thing is that the world is about to experience a strange bird, bigger than eagle, bigger than any other animal, but it's going to be a very strange bird. I don't know how that bird looks, but the bird is going to be so scary, but it's a bird. And we're also going to have a lot. How do I mean by a lot? Strange animals. I've spoken about this last year. Strange animals. These are the end signs. About more animals with double head, triple head. Strange animals. Very strange animals. The Lord is going to allow them come into the city. We are not really going to see them in the bush. Huh? The Lord is going to allow some strange animals from the forests to come out to the cities in countries so that you will see some creations we've never seen before. Are you understanding what I'm saying? And we are also going to experience more wolves. Yeah. Wolves will be so much. They'll be growing with speed. Wolves will be increasing. And strange animals that have long time gone, we will experience it. Yeah. Strange animals that have, they call them this dinosaur. Yeah. We will physically see a dinosaur that will come to the city. Nobody can hide it. So these are the end time signs. So we are going to see dinosaurs into the city. It's not what they will frame and no. You will see it. People with cameras will be on a far distance. I don't know when it will happen. Don't ask me when. You understand? So we pray about that part. So we should just pray. It is very, very old. And there is something they call in Nigeria, locally called baby bush. It's been long. We experience such kind of thing. I don't know what baby bush looks like. Baby bush. We are going to experience baby bush where people will not be coming out in the night. If it sees you in the night, it will scrub your body. I don't know how they experience it, but we're going to have baby bush where a lot of people will not be coming outside. We are getting into the era where people will not be staying outside. The moment is 8, 9 p.m. Those strange animals will be coming out as a daytime. When the day is coming out, they will go inside. So we're getting close to that stage. Are you understanding me? I won't mention the country, but there is a country that by 9 p.m. you will see the day. Sun will still be shining. Yeah, it's very close. By 9 p.m. sun will be shining. By 10, 11. Mass, the weather will start falling down like night. I don't know when it will happen. I don't know how it will happen. By 9 p.m., sun is still shining. By 10, it will become to dim. By 11, it's like 7. By 12, it will not be by 8. These are the signs. And each country, this thing will happen. There's going to be a big disaster. Natural disaster will happen. The moment those signs comes in those countries, it's a judgment sign. So, I'm not a doom. I'm just an information prophet that brings from God and tell you. The whole world might experience food scarcity. Not Africa alone, the whole world. We experience what? Food scarcity. Let's pray for the sea. And let's pray for people in the sea. Let's pray for the sea and let's pray for the ships in the sea. Let's pray for the marine workers in the sea. Let's also pray for those ships that goes under the water. I've forgotten the name. Those ones that goes under the water. When the sea will shake, many ship will sink. Submarine, everything will shake. Damages. The sea will not be stable. It's coming so close. We should pray that all the goods and everything in the ship, there shall be peace, because the sea, there will be a lot of shakers. So those who know their God are protected. Those who believe in God, nothing will happen. But those doubters who are accusing, it's okay. On that day, the last days, we will know. Thank you. Good night. Good night. You are blessed in the name of Jesus. Amen. They just gave you a citizenship. Your exam is next week. Go and become a citizen of that nation. In Jesus' name. Well, now, bye-bye.